Hey guys, Spirit of the Law here. In this video, we're going to take a look at the new patch that was dropped yesterday. It's another big one with some major balance changes and a brand new unique unit being thrown in there as well. Let's check it out. The first thing, just to quickly mention it, is the new celebration event. The idea is to have spring-themed icons and graphic mods you can unlock by meeting certain challenges over a 2-week period. The challenges are pretty easy, so you don't really have to go out of your way to get them, and you can unlock new icons, floral explosions to replace normal explosions, and flowers replacing arrows, that sort of stuff. It also changes the saturation of the civilization colors, so if they look a little odd in this video, that's why. Onward to the balance changes though. The first is the Step Lancer gets +1 attack. I'm starting to think I can make a career out of just updating the Step Lancer video. This is after it dropped by 2 and their attack speed was lowered in December, after which they became quite situational and arguably a little weak. It's hard to say if this is enough, but to put it in perspective, before the change, 27 Tatar Steplancers against 23 Knights lost with the Knights having just under half their HP left. Doing that test again now, the Knights end up with just over a third of their HP. That shows you how much of a difference even just one attack can make, and why these things are so hard to balance. This doesn't address the Steplancer's weakness to arrows, but it should have a noticeable effect in melee fights. The next change is to the Chinese, who no longer have redemption. Recently, they had block printing added, giving 3 more range to their conversions, so I guess it's meant to offset that. Taking away redemption means they'll now no longer be able to convert either buildings or siege. Chinese can be quite a strong civilization in the late game, even without monks, and this seems geared to a high level of play to me, so I doubt it'll really impact the average player. Moving on, the Kumans also lose redemption, making this a bit of an anti-redemption patch. They're also given the capped ram in Castle Age, which complements their battering ram in Feudal Age bonus. To compare the two, the capped ram has a bit more HP, a bit more bonus damage against buildings, and maybe most importantly, a bigger blast radius, so it's a solid upgrade for only 300 food. The Kuman unique unit, the Kipchak, also fires an extra arrow, back to their original number of 3 for non-elite and 4 for elite. The unique tech Step Husbandry was also changed, so it now reduces their training time by 50% instead of 80%. Another way to word that is that they train twice as fast now instead of 5 times as fast. This also applies to Step Lancers now and affects Cavalry Archers, so you're essentially getting double production speed on all 3 of those units. For those counting, that's 2 buffs and 2 nerfs, but I think is overall a slight improvement. We'll likely see more of their ramps, and the Kipchak buff is probably deserved. Next up is the Goths, who are feeling a little all over the place the last 2 patches. Last month, their infantry discount was expanded into Dark Age, making them probably the best militia-rushing civilization. That's been offset now by having a staggered discount, from a 20% reduction in Dark Age, increasing by 5% with every age. Unfortunately, that means their Feudal and Castle Age infantry are more expensive than they were to begin with. They also lose access to the tech Arson, and instead, their attack against buildings is staggered. In a way, it's kind of like free Arson, but they only get half the effect in Castle Age. I'm not really sure if Goths are better or worse after all of these changes. Does a 20% reduction in Dark Age actually offset making them weaker in Feudal and Castle Age, since that was already a bit of a weakness for them? I wouldn't be surprised at all to see yet another change for them in the next patch, to be honest, or even just reverting them back to where they were to begin with. Personally, I think their eco bonus had more room to address their early game if that was considered the weakness, rather than tweaking the infantry discount. Next up, an even larger change was to the Tatars. First of all, they gained Thumb Ring in addition to Parthian Tactics for free, which is great both for the crossbow and especially the cavalry archer line. They also had their unique unit training time reduced, on top of lowering its gold cost recently. Another change is the Steplancers now are affected by silk armor, so basically more pierced armor from their Castle Age unique tech, on top of +1 attack and a hill bonus. As well, their Trebuchet unique tech was updated to increase their range from +1 to +2, giving them up to 19 range. If that wasn't enough, they also get a new unique unit, the Flaming Camel. To start with the Camel, it says it's a fast-moving petard with bonuses against mounted units and elephants, which makes it sound like an anti-unit petard equivalent instead of being strictly anti-building. Overall, it's a pretty extreme change to the Tatars. Basically, everything is improved at once. I always thought Tatars felt a bit odd, partly because they lacked an obvious go-to strategy, and they're still a bit eclectic, but at least they're better at all of those random things that they can make now. So those are the balance updates, but the patch also included a few other notable changes that I want to point out. The first is that they're including 4 new missions in the Art of War tutorial. Art of War definitely helps new players jump into the game, and the new missions center around choosing counter units, siege units, naval battles, and battle formations. These are all really important things to know about, and I'm sure will speed up the learning curve for new players, especially people aiming to play online. And speaking of which, the online map pools have been updated, including separate pools for 1v1 and team games. Something that jumps out to me right away is that there's no longer a 1v1 Black Forest or Islands option. I think it's the right call to have a different map pool for 1v1 and team games, as they're a totally different beast. You're also able to look at the tech tree while queuing in matchmaking, which was a very common request. In addition, there's also two brand new maps included. The first is called Four Lakes. Just like it says, regardless of the number of players that are in the game, it always generates four lakes, with good fishing in the corners. Other than that, resources look pretty standard. It seems like an interesting balance between being greedy to grab lakes and fish, while at the same time not leaving yourself open to attack on land. The other new map is called Golden Swamp. It has the same basic concept as Gold Rush and Golden Pit, with a bit of starting gold around you and then a lot in the middle, with the special twist of also having fishing and water around the gold. I expect a lot of demo ships and a mix of water and land units on that map, and it certainly seems like an interesting one. Getting away from ranked games, in the unranked lobby you can also now apparently see your ELO rating. I tried it out and I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong, but I don't see them either when browsing for a game or when I'm actually in a lobby to start one. I'm not sure if I'm just unlucky and running into people who haven't played ranked, or if this one is still in progress. There are also various map changes to Alpine Lakes, Arabia, Arena, Hideout, and Mega Random. I won't go into them in detail, but they probably won't be too noticeable, as most are about distributing resources in a more balanced way. Also, something that's kind of cool is there are a few graphics changes. For example, the Eastern European set of naval ships has a new sail, which I think is a reference to the symbol for Orthodox Christianity, for people who care about that sort of detail. Relics are also a bit brighter, so that they'll be easier to see. Overall, they're definitely small changes, but to me it's just nice to see they care about that level of detail. As well, a great new quality of life feature that was added is you can now use Shift-Click to decrease your queue by 5. Previously, you could hold Shift and click to add 5 of a unit, but to remove them, you had to click them one at a time. I think that's a nice change. There was also another round of updates for the AI, but this time was mostly for occasional or rare bugs. I'd say it was less of an overhaul than it has been in some previous patches. Unit behavior and pathfinding was addressed again, as well as some nondescript changes to performance, both of which I hope they'll continue to incrementally improve over time. So overall, this patch has some really nice updates and solid balanced changes. With the new civilizations, it seems like we've gone through the overpowered and overcorrected phases, and we're getting to something more stable with the Cumans in particular. On the other hand, Tatars seem like they might be very strong now, and we'll just have to see how that plays out. But that's all for this one. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.